Joining me now for Ironman.com is David Goggins, and he's a SEAL, and he's a crazy man because he tells me that he's actually never done an Ironman before, but he's done an Ultraman, and so it should be a walk in the park, don't you think?
Well, I hope so, but it looks pretty evil out here, just like the Ultraman did. The Ultraman was actually my first triathlon I've ever done. I've never done a sprint or anything like that before, so hopefully I can do well in this race in the Ironman, so I'm looking forward to it.
Well, you should get off to a flying start, no pun intended. Tell us about your start.
Well, the start's going to, actually for us, I'm actually going to be in the airplane at 6 o'clock in the morning, mm-hmm. flying overhead about 1,200 feet, and about 6:35, we're going to be jumping out of the airplane into the Kona, Ironman. And we hit the water, a boat picks us up, and myself and Keith Davids are going to go to the start line of the swim and then do the whole race. So we'll see how that goes.
So actually, you're going to swim about 2.6 miles then?
Roughly, yeah, about 2.6, right, instead of 2.4.
Mate, I'd be asking the C-130 captain to take you out to about halfway in the swim and plonking you out there.
I like that better. I like that a lot better.
All right, now tell us, you know, some of your missions, include, you know, going into precarious places and doing, you know, just great things for our country, I certainly appreciate what you do. I am an American citizen as well as an Australian citizen, and it's fantastic. So let us know about what you've been doing lately.
Well, lately here, I just got back from Iraq, and now I'm just here kind of spreading the word about fitness. You know, the SEALs have taken upon themselves to go around and spread the word about, you know, obesity in America is getting pretty bad. So we're going around right now, setting up Navy SEAL fitness challenges and going around and trying to educate people on just how to be, you know, just fitter people. So that's what I'm going around now doing, spreading the word, you know, motivating people. Because I used to weigh 280, and now I weigh like 190. Mm-hmm. So, you know, go around and tell people, hey, go out there, run a couple minutes a day, you know, bike, you know, do some exercises, just get in shape.
Okay, now race day, what's your goals?
Well, my goals, I just want to take it easy. Have a good race, not blow up, not try to compete against some of these great athletes. I'm a ultra distance person. I'm not a, this isn't a short distance by any means, but these people who are great, like the, you know, Chris McCormick's, people like that, can redline for a whole race and finish in like 8 hours. And I would, that's just amazing to me. So my thing is to do my race, and whatever that is, that's what it is.
And just quickly give us an idea of what your weekly mileage would be, swimming, biking, and running.
Well, I'm kind of a crazy guy. I overtrain for everything I do. I'm not a triathlete by any means. I just train. So my weekly mileage on the run is about 120, 125. And I bike about 200 to 250 miles a week. And I swim anywhere from 8 to 10 miles a week. So I'm a big ultra runner is what I am. And everything else is kind of cross training.
Yeah, I was going to say, you're pretty heavily weighted on that final right. discipline. I don't think we're going to have any problems spotting you coming into the finish line with all that run mileage. You'll be the guy that just wants to say, can I just do another loop of the run?
Pretty much. Yeah, I'm not too good on the bike or the swim, but when it comes to running, I'm okay. I'm decent.
So what about those words, you are an Ironman? Mike Riley will announce you across the line and get that coveted Ironman medal. That's pretty special, huh?
Oh, it is. I mean, for everybody who does this race, and including myself, it's this is the race. Kona is the race. And for me to be here jumping into it, it's very special for me.